Hello, hello, hello. So I'm finally finishing, or not even finishing, I'm finally making this video. Can you believe it? Because I sure can't. I've been saying I was gonna make this video since like last year, and I didn't actually make the video for last year. So welcome to my very first sketchbook tour video. That's right, it's finally here. So this is my sketchbook from 2020. The artwork is by Andrew Jones on the outside, and it is a paper blanks sketchbook. These are great. I really suggest these to any artist. They can be quite expensive. They're about, you know, between 25 and 30 quid here in the UK, so they are a little bit expensive, but I think they're really worth it. The pages don't bleed through too much, and the paper quality is really nice. And if you want to keep things, it has a little pocket thing. Like, I don't really have anything in mind, but if you want to, it does. I finished this sketchbook. I started it in January, and I finished it in the middle of November, I think. So I have 1 month to spare. I moved over from this sketchbook after I finished it to this sketchbook. This sketchbook, I wanted this one for a while just because I absolutely love the art. The artwork is just so beautiful. So when I finish this one, you'll have another sketchbook tour just like this one. But they're both paper blanks. This one is slightly bigger, I think. Oh no, they're the same size. It's just a bit chunkier because I finished it. Enough babbling on my half. I hope you enjoy it, and thank you for watching. It's a slightly long video, it's about 25 minutes. But if you want to see what the inside of my sketchbook looks like, because I've had a few people ask me what the inside of my sketchbook looks like and that they'd like to see it, and they were looking forward to a sketchbook tour video, so here it is. Blessed be, guys. Thank you so much for coming to watch my video. I hope you all have a lovely end of the year, and yeah, I hope you're all doing well. Bye. So we'll start really simply. I've had to do a voiceover. This is just the art for my sketchbook. I wanted to show it with the flash on, and I wanted you all to be able to see what it looked like. So now we'll just go straight into it. I always leave the first page blank. That's just how I roll. So this is the first official page showing the date, the little bit of writing, and the forest spirits from Princess Mononoke that I cut out and stuck in here. I always do poems in this book, so you'll see that as we go. I was really inspired by like a Kraken sort of Cthulhu style for this, and I wanted to draw some tentacles. This one is just a cutout from another sketchbook, and I really wanted to draw some eyes, so that's how this one came to be. I wanted to add a bit more texture. I started getting into washi tape when I did this page, and you'll see more washi tape throughout. Another cutout from a little pattern that I was doing. And I just wanted to add it into the sketchbook so I could start going. This one, I love drawing fairies, and this is one of my more favourite ones. You can actually find a digital version of this on my Instagram. I also sometimes use Indian ink when I'm drawing because it saves liquid from my other pen. So that's why this one's a bit patchy, but I just really wanted to use the Indian ink for this particular piece. And this one, I wanted to do a bit more Zentangly, like humanoid creature looking thing. And that's how this one came out, by just bringing in the Zentangle. This one is just a self-portrait, but I wanted to try a different style to my usual style. Again, making it more Zentangly and adding some of my poetry. I drew this one whilst I was re-watching the This Is England TV show. It's inspired by the third season when they're in the 90s, hence the bucket hat. Mixed in with Zentangle, and I coloured it after, like quite a few weeks after, when I got new pens. I call these two the sexy eyes. I really wanted to draw some bodies but couldn't be bothered drawing heads, so they became the sexy eyes. And I also drew this other one, because it is a character from my X-verse. You'll see lots of those characters in here. I haven't drawn him in a little while, so I thought now was the time to draw him and colour him. He's based on Jin. My mossy girl, as I call her. I was really happy with how the hand came out for this one, and I wanted to try different colours, so I used green, because I don't use green very much in my drawings. This one became a Manifest March prompt. I think it was meditation. But I really enjoyed drawing this one. It was fun to do the line art, and it just came out really nice.
two pages of mandalas because I absolutely adore drawing mandalas. I had loads of fun drawing both of these and just practicing my Zen tangle and adding them into different types of mandalas, mixed in with poetry, of course. You'll find lots of poetry throughout this video. I really wanted to draw like big manga-y, like Dragon Ball Z here, so this was sort of inspired by that style of manga and anime. Another mandala mixed in with a bit of random internal monologue, because that's just how I roll, that's what I do. This one became a prompt for Manifest March, which was Shadow Self. I also did a poem or a small rap for this particular prompt, but I added a digital version of this drawing. This page is based on the Ophanim, the biblical angels, which are described in the Bible. When I found out about them, I thought they were really cool, so I wanted to have a go at drawing them in my own style, and I had a lot of fun just making these. Another one that became a Manifest March prompt, Celtic was the prompt. I based this on a photo set that Grimes, my favourite singer, uploaded, and I just love how the line art came out. It's one of my more manga-y looking pictures, and it also became part of the Girls with Swords series. You'll find this on my profile too. This other one was just a poem that I really wanted to do, and then I just added the manga girl falling in the background, and it came out looking a bit more comic-y than I was first expecting, but I was really happy with how it came out. I was really in the mood to just draw hair with this one, and I was going for a more zentangly detailed sort of look for the hair, so that's how this one came to be. Another poem, which started off as just the poem, and then I added the fairy and the zentangle in the background, and I wanted to add a bit of colour because every few pages I add some colour in. More Girls with Swords. This is part of the same one as the Celtic one, again based on some pictures that Grimes uploaded to her Instagram profile, the poses and the swords themselves. I was going for just, I just wanted to draw swords, to be honest, mixed with manga girls. This is where I started really having fun with washi tape. I got this new washi tape from Etsy that I really liked, and I wanted to do a little bit more of a comic booky sort of thing. I put washi tape on here and then peeled it off, so it gave it a sort of comic booky feel. I also added my poetry in, and because I wanted the comic thing to look straight and I wanted you to be able to see it, I didn't really add much else to these pages. So this is probably my most barren, so to speak, page. Like, there's not much going on, but I really wanted you to see the washi tape. These two became Manifest March pieces as well, and the spirit guide prompt, and it's the phoenix and the raven, but in Zentangle. These two birds are my guides, and I wanted to draw them. This was one of my more disassociative drawings. Sometimes when I have a really bad depression bout, I like to draw weird things, and at that particular day I felt like my brain was on fire, so I manifested it as a candle face drawing, and I also cut out bits of the washi tape so it looked a bit more in-depth, because I really wanted to add layers and I wanted you to see the layers. So that's how this one came to be. This was just messing around with washi tape and adding color, because I don't have many pages where it's straight color in the book. I drew this one whilst I was watching the Bicentennial Man again, and I really wanted to draw like a sort of androidy cyborg type of girl, which sort of went with the theme of the film that I was watching. Great film, you should give it a watch if you haven't. This one ended up becoming a digital piece I did recently where I've mirrored her face, and it became like a Gemini energy sort of picture, and I was messing around with colour and the way colour works, and I was using felt tip pens. A little bit more colour and messing around with washi tape. I was really going through a like experimental phase with my art at this point. This one I really enjoyed drawing because I loved the like thunder, like lightning bolt sort of look. And I did a sort of Zentangle pattern with the tree. I was watching Into the Wild whilst I was drawing this, and it was just something to relax with and draw, and I really liked how the tree came out. So it was really fun to just do these Zentangly patterns and just zone out and just chill. Not all art needs to be rushed. This one I was drawing while I was having an existential crisis about death, as usual, because I have an existential crisis about death quite frequently. So it says, death is just the final hallucinogenic trip in this mortal dimension, and I am just the trip sitter, don't stress. It's just the way that I cope with thinking about how, you know, we're all gonna move on to the next realm one day, but thinking of it as a hallucinogenic trip, the final one in this mortal pain, makes me feel better about it. So that's how this manifested. And I like drawing Grim Reapers, always been like that. And I use a lot of washi tape. This one was based on another manifest march prompt. I think it was Gaia. This was around the time the mermaid started, so we're roughly in May. I really like this Zentangle pattern for clouds that I found, so I went a bit ham drawing this pattern over a few pages. You're gonna see a lot of mermaids as we go from here. This page took me 2 days, I think, or a day and a half. I started doing this swirly pattern, which I really enjoy drawing. You'll see a lot of that over this video, and I wanted to add more Zentangle clouds. I really liked how the line art for the manga girl came out. I had a lot of fun drawing that, and I added in my poetry as well. This page I drew whilst I was on one of my rewatches of the 100, which happens a lot, more swirly lines. The drawing was based on Lexa and the whole Grounder aesthetic and their hair and the way they dress, and I just had a lot of fun drawing this one. The Angels Renaissance, I got some new washi tape as well. This one became a digital piece, which some of you who watch this might remember. I really wanted to showcase the different Zentangle swirls, and I also wanted to show the washi tape. This is one of the best hands I've ever drawn on anything, so I was really proud of this hand, and I just generally had a great time drawing this one. More Zentangle here, but I wanted to do straight curly Zentangle here. I wanted to be like proper Zentangle patterns rather than just lines. And I wanted to add a bit of colour. This one I drew whilst I was watching Seven, and I was going for pointillism. I was looking at a lot of Picasso stuff, and it's meant to be like hills, mountain, sun, sky. It didn't quite come out how I wanted it to, but it was fun to draw this and to just try something slightly different. So I'm glad that I did put it in. Another pointillism study thing that I was doing, I was trying to mix it with the manga. It didn't quite come out how I like it, and this is probably my least favourite drawing in this sketchbook. But, you know, you've got to test out things and try new things, and this was just one of those things that didn't sit right. This drawing, on the other side, is from a continuous line series that I do, where I just do one line for the entire thing and then go over it in pen to thicken it up. You can find the other ones on my Instagram profile. This is where we're starting to get into OCs now, so my original characters. This is Sumi, and she's a vampire. She's one of the main characters in my X-verse. She'll pop up quite a bit in this video. I like to just draw them, my characters, and then put some information about them, a little bit of their backstory on the other page. Another X-verse OC. This is the main protagonist of the entire world. Her name's Goldira. Sometimes I call her G. She is a fire witch and a demigod, and I draw her so much. I do these pages when I just want a bit of escapism, and I'll just write about them. This is Negrira, who is the main antagonist of the X-verse, and she is Goldira's aunt. And I haven't drawn her very much, so I wanted to draw her again and write a little bit about her. Just a straight Zentangle piece. I think I had a bit of art block whilst I was doing this, so I just wanted to get something down in the book, and this is what I came up with at the time. And on this page, I did the poem first and then just added the Zentangle after. I got really into these swirly lines. They will just keep coming. Expect more of them throughout this entire video. And this is Axela. She is a vampire from my X-verse. She is the main nemesis of Sumi, the other vampire, and she works with Negrira too. I really wanted with this one just like split hair, so it'd be easier to colour in sections, and I also wanted to draw loads and loads of eyes, as you can see. I was really proud of how the hands came out. I'm not sure if you can really see it in this video very well, but these were some hands that I was really happy that I drew. You know, I didn't trace or anything, it was all just from study. And now we move on to the box people. I wanted to just draw without really having to draw faces, and so I made a few pages where I've just drawn these box people in different positions. It was a great opportunity to just practice body positions and to just have a bit of fun, do some Zentangles. This one I drew when I was over someone's house and they just kind of wanted to watch me draw. I didn't really use a reference for this on anything, so it was just straight out of my head instead of like practicing references and looking at positions. And I did the Zentangle a little bit like later, a few days later. More split here, but this time with Zentangle in the background. I just love dividing pages up into sections and then doing things within the sections of the hair like that. This is like the only double spread that I've done in this way. This was another mermaid prompt. This was the monarch butterfly prompt, and I absolutely love butterflies. Monarch butterflies are one of my favorite types of butterflies. This one was actually really hard to draw because when I drew it, I hadn't drawn much else in the book, and so the leveling was quite hard to line it up. So it was quite challenging to draw this one, but I had fun drawing it. The hair took forever. And we continue with mermaid. Both of these became digital pieces for mermaid, which you can find on my profile, adding washi tape in as always. Another mermaid for mermaid. I really wanted to get involved this year because the year before and the year before that I wasn't as involved. So I just did that. This one, I did the poem first and then added the swirly pattern in. I really wanted to try and colour the pattern this time instead of just leaving it straight black and white. But I had a lot of fun just doing this little Zentangle page. I don't like to draw humans all the time. I'm really gutted that I didn't do this pattern more. I only did this pattern once, but I found it and I fell in love with it. So hopefully I'm going to do it again at some point. Another mermaid, which became another mermaid prompt. It's pretty standard. Oh, and look, more mermaids. I think we're slowly coming to the end of the mermaids now because mermaid was over, so May was coming to an end. The koi mermaid is based on an old drawing I did from 2017. I just wanted to recreate it. And this other one, I just did a green one because why not? I coloured it a bit later though. Yeah, and we're at the end of mermaid now. I drew this one because I was fed up of drawing mermaids. I wanted to start drawing legs again, and you can sort of see it manifesting in the character's face. I found a pink pen that still worked, which made me really happy because pink is my favourite colour. And I also just really love the way the flowers came out. I really enjoy drawing these flowers like simple mandalas. This one sort of goes with the Girls with Swords series. I found a reference for a pose and I really love the proportions and how it came out, and the Zentangle pattern in the background was a new one that I found which I incorporated in, and I really enjoyed doing it. This is another one. This is Sumi and this is her twin sister Suki. They are both the characters in my X-verse. You've seen Sumi before. I just made this poem. It was based on their characters and also inspired by my best friend. This one, I wasn't really going for anything in particular. I think I just really wanted to draw that day and I was struggling to come up with something. I wanted to draw some form of human with Zentangle in the background, or like an alien-y sort of girl, because I never do normal skin colours and hair colours. This one, I did the leafy pattern first and then I did the face and the rest of it, and it sort of just evolved from that and it became a strange sort of concept. I've done a Instagram version, a digital version too. One of my double spreads inspired by my pumpkin patch one I did last year. I really wanted to draw a tower. I was so happy with how this little bridge came out, even though it was a really simple part of it and not even a main part, but I just really enjoyed doing this one. And I switched off from Instagram for a couple of days to do this and it was really relaxing. I'm not sure where this one came from. I just really wanted to draw a girl with horns. I have no idea or can't remember what the inspiration was behind this. I was just really vibing with the Girls with Horns sort of thing, and then that's how this manifested. The Zentangle moth. Again, I love moths just as much as I love butterflies, and I really wanted to do a Zentangle moth. The background didn't come out really in a great way. It sort of drowned out a lot of the drawing, but I was happy with it anyway. I saw this outfit on a model on a picture online, and I just really wanted to draw the dress, and I got some more washi tape and I wanted to incorporate that in. This piece was inspired by my weekend in North Wales. I'd never been to North Wales before and I was just awestruck by the entire thing. The mountains were incredible. Like, the mountains are beautiful in South Wales where I'm from, but the mountains in North Wales were just next level and it just really left an impression on me. And I also included a little fly agaric in here as well because it's one of my favourite mushrooms, and I saw one on the trip and I'd never seen one in real life before, so I just wanted to make a drawing based on my weekend there with my friends. This one is just a pattern that I found that I really enjoyed. I was having a bit of art block and I decided, what the hell, I'll just draw the pattern out. and I actually had a lot of fun just zoning out drawing this. It was great times. I was in a very like snake mood on this particular day. Like, this first one is based on Medusa with the snake hair, and I just felt like drawing some snakes, and I wanted to practice and use Entangle background as well, so that's how this one manifested. This one, it looks like a mermaid, but I was actually going for like a more like serpentine serpent girl, so it was meant to be like a serpent tail, and I really wanted to do the swirly tail as well. Another one where I didn't really know what to draw, I just knew I wanted to draw something, so I ended up drawing some like angel and devil looking cute ghosts, and I drew the starry background and then added in the line background after it. The return of Goldira, she is my absolute treasured and oldest OC. I drew her for the first time when I was 11, I created her when I was 11, and I just always feel at peace when I bring her into my art, and this is just what this page was. More split hair, again with the sections, just messing around. I started doing this starry background and it just ended up coming into loads of my art pieces, and I wanted to do it without making it a full page, so I split with the hair. More washi tape and a Zentangle thing that I was just doing just because I wanted to draw something. This is my two-page comic that actually took me a day and a half to do. I was just getting some feelings and thoughts out onto paper, and it's all just about holding on and hanging on for love because I'm a hopeless romantic. I had a lot of fun drawing this one. I absolutely love bringing fairies into my art, so that's what this page was, and I just found this new sort of Zentangle liney twirly background thing that I really wanted to bring into my art, so that's how this happened. And some of my poetry as per usual, because it's on practically every page. A Zentangle dragon skull, because I have this habit of drawing skulls with Zentangle patterns in the background. I think I was having a bit of withdrawals from not playing Skyrim for ages. This one I did as a piece for Witchtober, I think, and for the prompt the Lovers. Axela and Sumi. Just wanted to draw them together because I really draw them together, and I was trying to draw a different face for my villains, but I didn't quite like how Axela's face came out for it, so when I redrew it digitally, I edited the face a bit. This is Kiami from the X-verse. She is a water elf. I haven't drawn her in a little while, so I wanted to just get her and some of her backstory in too. Suki and Dark Suki, both the same characters, two different variations of her. She is also from the X-verse. She is what I call an element phantom. I will explain that one day when I eventually write a bit more, but a bit more backstory here, and just wanted to draw her two different like styles and the way she looks. This is my character Omira. She is from the Soul Surfers universe, which is like my secondary universe I don't spend as much time in and is more new. It's only been going since 2017, instead of X-verse, which has been going since like I was 11. I really enjoy her color palette, and I just love drawing her. She's one of my absolute favorite characters to draw, and I hadn't drawn her in a little while when I drew this. I was really struggling to come up with something to draw today, but I wanted to draw someone with two faces, and so I came up with this weird sort of concept. I'm not sure where I was going with it, but this is what came out. My shroom babes, my fly agaric babes, I just wanted to draw my favourite mushroom mixed in with like mangery bodies, and here are some more. I ended up doing a digital version with all of them on one page, which was really fun to draw, and the background started getting really detailed by this point. I got even more washi tape at this point for my birthday, and there was like some really lovely like witchy washi tape, so I just wanted to like incorporate that in with one of my drawings and more of the swirly backgrounds. I think I was just passing time this day, and that's how it manifested. Sumi again, I absolutely love drawing this character. I just added a poem in this time though, and I really like how the proportions came out, and she looked quite mangery. I was happy with how the face turned out, so I just brought her in as well. I did this for Witchtober as well, I think, and this is based on the tarot card The World, and I really liked how this one came out. It was slightly more of a challenge for me, which I was quite happy with. I like how it came out. Another Zentangle piece, the sort of like the other Zentangle piece from a little bit further back. Pumpkin babes, I was really in the Samhain Halloween spirit, and I wanted to go off the Fly Agaric babes and do pumpkin versions of them, practicing poses and whatnot. The Plague Doctor, I was really in the mood to draw a Plague Doctor this day, and that's how it came out. I had a lot of fun. I also got this like really beautiful washi tape, just very witchy looking and thick, and I just wanted to add it in. This is my pumpkin stump. I did a digital version of it, you can find on my Instagram. Goldira once more. This time I was talking about a concept called the dark flame, which is one of her powers, and I wanted to like do a drawing so you could see that, and I wanted to write a bit about it so I could remember it later. This is one of my absolute favorite pieces of line art. I was so happy with how this came out. It just looks really mangery, the proportions are all right, and I was just so proud of myself, and the hair came out nice too. I drew this whilst I was watching the film The Hole. It's like a psychological thriller with Keira Knightley. I just really was happy with how it came out. Another Girl with Swords, which I suppose is part of the Girls with Swords series, but I haven't done anything with it digitally yet, but the starry background started getting so detailed by this point. This is New York. She is another character from my X-verse, and she is also a vampire, and I just wrote a little bit about her backstory. I've been writing her little novella slash book for quite a few years, but I lost the first chapter a few years ago on one of my old iPods, so I just wanted to redraw her so I could remember what she looked like, and I just wanted to have a record of her in this book. I couldn't really work out what to draw with both of these pages, and when I drew this one I knew that I wasn't like drawing the legs how I wanted to, so I just masked it with a bit of starry looking stuff that was like absorbing her or coming out of her hands. This one was supposed to be a mandala, but it ended up being a weird sort of like flower thing. Just a bit of art block drawing for you. Yet another character from my X-verse, this is Sheen. She's also a vampire. I just wanted to add her in because I haven't drawn her in a few years, and I just wanted a record of her too. And the final page, I was back on the mandala hype at this point. You'll see that in the next sketchbook, it carried on to that. So I just added that in. I wanted the last two pages to be quite simple and chill. And for the final piece, I did a Zentangle outline of Wales, which is my home country, and I put a little heart down by where Cardiff is roughly on the map, because it's my hometown, my home city, where I was born, where I've lived my entire life, and I just wanted to add that in here so everyone could see it. So that's my sketchbook, people. That's it. That's the whole thing. I can't believe I've actually made this video finally. Just a quick flick back through so you can see it in like a big chunk. I was really happy with how this sketchbook came out, and I can't wait to start the new one, or finish the new one even, because I've started it. And thank you for joining me on this journey, and I hope you enjoyed this video.